Thank you. First, I just want to thank some of my closest friends and supporters standing behind me, and I also want to thank so many members of the media for attending today, which promises to be a very pivotal and monumental election cycle, to say the least. I'm here today to announce my formal candidacy to become a candidate for the Democratic nomination for State Auditor. The first and obvious question is why? Why? I believe elected office shouldn't be about being comfortable or complacent, but rather it should be about the challenge and commitment to reforming and improving government on every level. 5 years ago, I could have taken the easy road and run unopposed for a fourth term to the Massachusetts State Senate. Instead, I saw an opportunity to reform an antiquated and outdated institution at the Worcester County Sheriff's Office. Challenging the political establishment and against long odds, not only did we succeed, but we instituted over 50 new reforms, including in first of its kind, an anti-nepotism policy, a responsible fatherhood initiative, a first-of-its-kind halfway house focused on drug rehabilitation and reintegration, senior citizen triad programs, a record number of community service programs saving taxpayers millions of dollars throughout central Massachusetts, and receiving national recognition and accreditation by the American Correctional Association. Simply said, promises made, promises kept. 5 years later, I can take that easy road again, and I can seek re-election based on the success we've experienced, or I can embrace a new challenge of modernization, innovation, and reform as State Auditor. I believe the Auditor's Office can and should be more than just a fiscal watchdog. I believe the State Auditor's Office can be on the front lines of job creation, reducing property taxes, economic development, and good government. You might ask me, well, geez, how can the auditor play such a role? First, with job creation, working with labor, I will commission a report on studying the effect of hiring out-of-state employees and contractors, including the cost to the Commonwealth when it comes to unemployment insurance, benefits, and lost revenue. We need not only to create, but also to retain and keep jobs in the Commonwealth. Property taxes, a major issue across the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. The auditor, in advocating and working with cities and towns, can play a key role in curbing and reducing unfunded state mandates that are financially crippling our local cities and towns. Economic development. The auditor can play a key role in ensuring stimulus funding is being spent wisely, appropriately, and with the greatest impact. In addition, the auditor can play, again, a vocal role in ensuring that stimulus funding is steered toward economic development projects and not simply to fill budget deficits. In good government, there are so many examples. Right now, I'll give just one. The Commonwealth spends more than $100 million a year on rent for office space. As auditor, I will spearhead an effort to dramatically reduce this cost by better utilizing surplus property that is currently underutilized or unused. In addition, I want to expand the auditor's office to be an effective advocate for taxpayers by exposing waste and fraud through improvement of citizen-based reporting. Simply said, I want the auditor's office to be a marquee constitutional office that has the resources, determination, and commitment to make government more effective and efficient. As a legislator and as a sheriff, I've had a long history of marching to my own beat, being an independent, fiscal conservative, someone not afraid to take on the status quo. I've long championed tax relief and job growth for the middle class. I was one of only a handful of Democrats in the legislature to actually vote for a reduction in the state income tax to 5% and tackle controversial issues like bilingual education reform. As auditor, I will continue that no-nonsense independent approach, ensuring the auditor's office is an independent, nonpartisan agency driven by the best interests of the taxpayers and not the status quo. Today, we all know we stand at a crossroads. Unemployment remains above 9%. Families are struggling to pay their mortgages. Property taxes continue to rise. The cost of public education, daily family expenses, and basic state services have all gone up. People across the state are both angry and frustrated. I stand before you not only as a proven agent of change, but someone focused and committed to bringing the accountability, innovation, and oversight the citizens of this great Commonwealth not only expect, but demand in their next state audit. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you.